That was unfortunate. Probably the most annoying thing, poison. Having this like glitchy crazy stuff happen. And again, I love telling stories from when I was younger, when I used to play Pokemon. I have like so many stupid stories to tell in regards to that. And in this case, when I was poisoned, I did not know what was happening to my game. I thought my game was freaking out. I thought it was like a bug or a glitch or something, but no. That's just like the kind of poison, just the poison screen every like few steps you take. When I was younger, didn't know that. Thought my game was broken, stuff like that. And I didn't know that it sapped HP from my Pokemon every single time I walked 5 or 6 steps or whatever it is. So that was always cool. My Pokemon would always faint. Because I didn't know. Fun times. I enjoy it. I don't want to fight this guy. Alright, let's see if I can get through this place without having to use Flash, because I actually didn't pick up an HM slave like I was talking about. This place is pretty easy to get through. It's just pretty much hugging walls and stuff like that. So I'm gonna hope that I can get through this without having to use Flash, because I don't have a Pokemon that can learn it, or if I do, it is more than likely Grovyle, and I'm not going to teach my main Pokemon a poopy HM move that I can't get rid of until like the last town we ever go to, the last city or town, whatever it is. Now I'm actually thinking of picking up a Makuhita. I say that because I rarely use it, and as far as I know, it's a decent fighting type, not taupe. But I believe it's fairly decent. I'm sure there's probably better fighting types out there other than Makuhita, but I still kind of want to use different Pokemon, and I really hope I'm going the right way. I still want to use like Pokemon that I don't normally use. And I've never actually used a Makuhita in any of my any of my personal playthroughs of any Pokemon game. And like I said, sounds like I'm on repeat, broken record, but like I said, I think it's a decent fighting type, so I might use it. I have no idea where I'm going, by the way. I'm just trying to follow walls. What is this? Rocks. Okay, that's great. That's not where I want to be. More rocks. Definitely not where... Oh my god. Please don't tell me I'm lost. I have no idea where I'm at. So that's good. I did this to myself, too. Which is the sad thing. And also, Zubat. I personally love Zubats. I know everybody hates them because they're always very abundant in caves, but I always love Zubat. Is the place I need to go up here? Yeah, I think it is. I was just dumb and thought that it was somewhere else. This is also another Pokemon that I was contemplating getting. Aeron, I think that's how you say his name. Like I said, I suck with pronunciations of Pokemon names and stuff like that, so please forgive me. I just say them how I think that they're supposed to be pronounced and stuff like that. But I think it's a decent Pokemon as well. Maybe not in the beginning, but Aggron, I think, is its final evolution. And that thing's a beast. There are probably Pokemon that are better than it, but like I said, never really used one, and it looks pretty beast, not gonna lie. And oh sweet Jesus, we got through this relatively painlessly. Oh yeah, another fun story from my childhood. You see those ledges right there to the right? I jumped down those first time I played through this game because I thought it took me to a different area. I didn't realize that this was the same area that you come in on. So I had to do everything all over again. Granted, it's a pretty short trek, but still, it was kind of poopy. That device you have there, it's a PokéNav. When trainers that have PokéNavs battle, it keeps a record of how things went, I think. Oh, pardon me, my name is Steven. I'm interested in rare stones, so I travel here and there. Oh, a letter for me?
And I don't know
that's the cat freaking out on my door, or Seamus. So that's nice. I try to let the cat in, but she's dumb. She's a cat. Wants to come in, wants to go out. And Steven has given us TM47, which is stealing, I believe. I think. I wasn't reading, so I don't know if that's what he said. But I'm pretty sure he gives you stealing. Because, noted by his gray hair and neutral color clothes, he likes steel-type Pokemon. So it's only fitting that he gives us a steel-type move. And yeah, my cat's like sneezing underneath the door. It's really creepy. How many bets that if I get up to go let her in again, she's just gonna run away and then I will have wasted time that I have to go back and edit out of the recording? So I'm just gonna let her be, because I'm thinking about wrapping things up in a little bit. I'll probably get the next gym badge and then maybe wrap things up. Things have been going pretty swell so far. Trying to get back into the groove of recording things and uploading consistently. I'm trying to make a promise to myself that I have let myself down and you guys down on in the past, because I'm always like, yeah, I'm gonna start uploading consistently and recording consistently, and then I never do it, which is it's kind of depressing. So I'm gonna really try to change that. And in all honesty, I should probably level up my Talo before I go onto this gym, but I'm not too worried about it. I'm actually gonna switch Talo out to the front, so this little birdie gets some experience from the regular trainers in this gym, which kind of cool twist is they made it so it looks like you have to use flash, but the light will get bigger with the more little gym trainers that you beat, which is really cool. I actually like the design that they implemented in this gym. I'm actually loving the remakes and stuff of the gym designs in Pokemon Heart Gold, Soul Silver. I like how they redesigned that, and then again in Pokemon Black and White, and Black 2, White 2. It's really cool how they just constantly keep changing that stuff. I really love it. They get really creative with some of the stuff that they do. There's actually been puzzles that have trumped me a little bit. Like in Pokemon Black 2, I'm just recently getting to the Pokemon League in that, because I'm playing it in my own personal time, and I haven't really played it consistently. I haven't just continuously played it every day, but it's actually really cool. The 8th gym leader, I forgot his name. I am so terrible with remembering things like this, but 8th gym leader, the water guy, that lily pad puzzle actually kind of stumped me a little bit. Like, I got through it, and I got the gym badge, and now I'm on my way to go face the Elite Four and stuff like that. But that was actually pretty clever, and I really like what they're doing with the gym designs in the new games. Love it. And why can I not kill this guy? Get out of here! I'm done with you! Go! In all fairness, I could have used Wing Attack. And holy crap, these guys give me so much experience because I'm fighting Pokemon that are around the same level as me. Forgot that I was, that my Talo wasn't really super overleveled or anything. But I'm just doing this for experience for my Talo, because I'm gonna be using Talo mainly in this upcoming gym battle. So might as well give this guy some experience. And he's earning a lot too. Every single battle I'm in, the enemy Pokemon just reward me so much experience. It's ridiculous. Like, here's a level up, I'm gonna be level 16. I forgot when Talo evolves. I think it might be level 22. I think maybe. Not sure though. And I'm already almost halfway to another level up. Like, this is ridiculous. Hurry up and get rid of these guys so I can defeat Brawly, hopefully, and end this recording session. My throat is actually getting a little sore from talking so much consistently in a short amount of time, for this half an hour that I've been recording, trying to talk nonstop and stuff like that. My throat is definitely not used to it anymore. Which kind of sucks because I'm going to need to do this. I'm going to need to like bulk record a ton for PAX Prime. How could I lose so easily? Because I have something that trumps your Pokemon. I think there might be one more random gym trainer, but even if there is, I don't care. I'm just gonna take on Brawly now. I'm Brawly, Dewford's gym leader, been churned in the rough waves of these parts, and I'm growing tough in the pitch black cave. So you wanted to challenge me? Let me see what you're made of. Alright, Brawly. His sprite looks kinda goofy, but he looks like a typical surfer dude kinda guy. He has like the crazy windblown hair look and stuff like that, and holy crap, I was not expecting his Pokemon to be the same level as my Talo. That was kind of a not so nice surprise. But he's just gonna sit here and use bull.